This week marks 100 years since more than a million Armenians were slaughtered under the Ottoman Empire. And for nearly that long, there's been an argument over to what to call what happened. So what does genocide mean?
Today, we call what happened at the Nazi death camps genocide. But back then, the word did not exist. It was created by Raphael Lemkin, a Polish Jew who had lost everything he had and everyone he loved. In 1944, he wrote a book about the Nazis. In it, he combined the Greek word genos for race with the Latin word side for killing. As a teenager, Lemkin learned through news accounts that the Turkish government was slaughtering its Christian Armenian citizens. The government claimed it was putting down an Armenian revolt. And over 8 years, it killed a million Armenian men, women, and children in massacres and forced marches.
So to this day, the Turkish government denies that what happened there was a genocide. Joining me now here in the studio is the Armenian ambassador to the UK, Armen Sarkissian. Welcome to the program.
Well, thank you for inviting me.
This is an ongoing struggle way after what actually happened on the ground. Does it matter what it's called?
Well, it does, Christiane, because in our life, words are not just words. In many cases, words have a very, very deep meaning, like a word honor, pain, love, humanity. Genocide. In the case of Armenians, the word genocide means 100 years of injustice, 100 years of pain, denial, and just remembrance of all what wrong happened.
President and former Prime Minister Erdogan has done more than many Turkish prime ministers to move towards that pain and injustice that the Armenians suffered. Still not calling it a genocide, but has done more to acknowledge what happened. How do you react to that?
Well, I would say that as a general move, I react positively, but I would consider it personally, not as an ambassador or a politician, as an Armenian, as a fellow Armenian. Something like it's one step forward, then two steps backwards. Because why? Because at the end of the day, saying the words, but the truth, but not the whole truth, doesn't help.
And yet, Ambassador, it's not just the Turkish government historically. It's here in Britain. It's the United States. They also don't use the word. Let me just also show you. We can talk about it in a second, but I want to show you what the Turkish foreign minister said to our Jake Tapper earlier this week.
We are not denying that so many people died, but we cannot characterize what happened as genocide. And it is not up to those parliaments and the politicians to decide whether it was a genocide or not.
So arguing over a technicality, it seems.
Well, it's not a technicality at the end of the day. Let me give you a couple of reasons why it's important.
I mean in terms of the word, obviously not in terms of what happened.
In terms of the word. First of all, that word exactly shows the truth, and truth matters, because it was organized by the Turkish government. Extermination of Armenians in the Eastern Anatolia and in the whole Turkish Ottoman Empire with a reason just to eliminate the whole nation. So there is no other words. And it doesn't matter, is it 1.5 million, a million, or even 20,000 that we saw recently in Europe, in the southeastern, western Europe, that 20,000 people killed for a specific reason of fate and belonging is clarified as a genocide. And I would like to remind Christiane that you said about Britain has not recognized yet, but there are around 30 countries, including big countries, that have basically recognized this terrible act as a genocide. The European Parliament, Parliamentary Assembly of the Council in Europe today, the Austrian government, and it's going to go more and more. That's the truth.
What are your relations with Turkey when you meet with their officials, when you have meetings?
Well, I am one of the rare Armenians that travels to Turkey. I know politicians. I have friends there. I have a lot of friends from intellectuals. Let me tell you why the word genocide is important, both for Armenians and Turks as well. First of all, as I told you, it's the truth and basically representing the truth. The second, It's important for Armenians. It's important for Armenians to remember who you are. It's inside, not in your genes, but you're in blood when you are born. I am.
Do you think the young generation feels that? I've seen quite a lot of writings about how there is a need to move forward.
Now there is a need to be moved, but the way forward goes through truth. If we deny, if we not say the truth, if we not say the truth, there are small regularities in the financial sector. We end up with a financial crisis. Burning coal is not so dangerous. We end up with a huge crisis in environment, food, and water. And we say, Armenian genocide, did it happen? Was it genocide or not? We end up a German leader telling his troops that who remembers Armenians today? And let's go and do the same or the worse to the 6 million of Jews.
So let me ask you then, you say more and more countries are beginning to come on your side on this particular issue. The Turkish government, the Turkish nation is commemorating Gallipoli, the Battle of Gallipoli of the World War I, just this week, in fact, on the anniversary. And top leaders, including Prince Charles, Prince of Wales from here, and others from around the world are going. What is your reaction to that?
Well, it's not my role to interpret why His Royal Highness is going there. First of all, he is the heir to the throne. Then he represents also the Commonwealth, and they lost. The question is not the Gallipoli. Why the commemoration of Gallipoli this year was moved for the usual date to the 24th of April? And I think the answer is very simple. I would call it it's small politics. Small in the sense that at the end of the day, there are several ways of leading people. You can play the politics, you can manipulate, but you can also lead with truth. And this is what exactly we all want, both Armenians and the Turks. Let me just say a very important thing. I think we, Armenians, you said, it's in the blood of us. We are sort of also not only victims, but also a hostage of the genocide. And it remembers that we have never to allow this to happen. And that's why Armenians fought in Nagorno-Karabakh, not only because they were right, but also because they didn't want to allow another genocide to happen. But the other hostage are the Turks. They are hostage of denial.
Very, very difficult history. Ambassador Sarkissian, thank you very much indeed for being with us on this 100th anniversary this week of that terrible situation.